Now comes probably one of the hardest parts of this job. I've got to cut out along my lines without damaging the other side of this panel or the underside of this panel where it overlaps. I can't help damaging the other side. I've got to cut it along here. I'm going to have to touch up the paint after I do this repair, for sure. I got the piece of metal cut out. It was difficult. I ended up using my grinder, some drill bits, a pair of pliers, screwdriver, and actually my air body saw helped out quite a bit. And I got it out. I didn't actually damage this. See, I didn't want to damage this part. I've only cut through the first layer, but I've got to get the rust off and whatever paint is on there. And get the rust off of here. I have to trim this a bit. It's not quite a perfect fit. I still have a little bit of, you know, a little bit. It's a little too long, but I think we can work with it. I'm also, see this part here, this piece of metal is all beaten and warped and beat out of shape. And I thought about what I could do about this. And I thought about ordering one online, because you can buy this piece of metal online. But I gave it a couple of measurements and I decided, well, that's just about exactly what a 2x4 piece of square steel is. So I went out today, 5-star steel, and I bought a 5-foot chunk of it. I decided to take out this whole rear piece. You can see here, I've got a piece of 2x4 square steel, and you can see the difference between my old original piece and the new one that I'm making. This one's been hit and beaten, squished and screwed up. So I'm going to take these brackets off, and I'm going to put them on this piece of metal. And lucky for me, they're just about identical size. I got to do a little bit of repair over here, where I had to cut out all the welds. But now it'll make it easier for me to straighten out this side too. I don't have to worry about bending anything. I can just set it up square and straight, do some measurements, weld it in. Just gotta do some rust removal and some panel repair and some measurements and some squaring things up and some, oh, work. A little bit of time has passed. I welded in some braces to keep this thing from spreading, because when I cut this section out, it spread apart a little bit. So I squished it back together and welded in all these 5 supports. And on the other side, I drilled all these holes to match exactly all the holes in the original piece. Now this part is ready to go on the truck, pretty much. Here's my new one. I cut the brackets off the other one. They were riveted on, and I bolted them onto here. I cut the bottom out of this piece of rectangular steel. It's a 2x4 piece of steel. It is 53 inches long. When I cut this bit out, I noticed this spread apart a little bit. So I'm going to have to weld in a couple of little pieces to pull this back in. I'll clamp it, weld the piece in, so it'll hold that straight. Got some weld through primer on it because I intend to put a few welds on it just to hold it even better. I've drilled some holes. Alright, now it's time to show you what I did today. Today, the first thing I did was I painted the inside of this channel iron with Pour 15. It's a lot easier for me to paint it right now. I also used some leftover to paint this side. I put some weld through primer on this after I welded it up a little bit. See from the burn marks here, I've been doing a little bit of welding on this. I welded up some of my holes that were in here. It's kind of rough, but I'm going to use some of that metal reinforced body filler for it. I cleaned out all the rust, surface rust off of here, and I put the weld through primer on here, and I fixed it up pretty good. Same thing on this side. Cleaned the rust off, weld through primer on it. This piece here, this corner of it, was in such bad shape, I decided to just cut it off, and I'll make a patch to replace that. Here's what I've got done now. I took this piece out, and I straightened it out. Just a little hammer and dolly on the bench there. And then I fixed up the one edge, and I tack welded it back in place. So now it's in there. And it's in line, it's straight enough. And it's in better shape now than it was before. And also, this side fits tighter and is in better shape than it was before. So, I might hammer and dolly this gap a little bit. But, next step is to do a little bit of fine-tuning on this patch. There's how it sits in place there. It's a little long on this end and a little long here. The bolt hole's kinda in there in the general area it's supposed to be. Alright, tubers, I've skipped ahead a little bit. I've trimmed this patch. I actually trimmed a little too much off of this side, but I can fill that gap, I think. I've got a little bit of a gap there. A little bit of a gap all the way around for the butt weld to fill in. And now I've got to tack it. I've got it clamped with some vice grip pliers. Actually, you know what I should do? I should drill for the plug welds. Damn, I forgot about those. I've drilled a few holes for the spot welds, and I've sprayed it with some weld through primer. Alright guys, the paint's all dried on the back of this now. Now I just clamp it in place and weld it in. Alright, so I've got it clamped in approximately where I think I need it. I've got it so it should line up nicely. This gap should line up nicely here. If not, I'll tack it in a few spots and I might hammer it just a little bit just to make it line up a little better. You can tell by my gap, I'm pretty amateur at this. I made a mistake, but I'm going to fix it with just weld. Alright, tubers, I've got a few tacks in place. And I'm going to show you something. See where this big thick gap is? I've made one little tack weld across it. And what I'm going to do is, from that tack weld, I'm going to do my tack welds off of that weld and keep going up until it's filled the gap. I'll keep tack welding next to this gap, next to this tack weld. Just a little bit at a time, and I'll make it up to the top. Got it all welded in. I'll come back with the grinder and smooth this all out. See if there's any gaps. If there's any gaps, I'll touch them up. It'll look a lot better once I grind it, that's for sure. Alright, now I've got the welds all ground down nice. And It's going to take a little skim coat of filler to cover that. But I needed a skim coat of filler to smooth out the irregularities and the rest of it anyway. Same thing over here. Not too terrible. Just a little skim of filler and that should fill it up. Anyway, I guess that's the end of the patch video.